So one of the new apps that comes with macOS Mojave is the Stocks app. The Stocks app has been around on the iPhone since the beginning, and now it finally makes its way to the Mac after all these years. And it's the new version of the Stocks app that you would find in iOS 12. So it has lots of news and information there. So let's take a look. You're not going to find it in the dock by default. At least I didn't on any of my Mojave installations. But you can search for it using Spotlight. So I'll do Command Space, search for Stocks, and it will come up. Now you can add it to the dock if you want. So the Stocks app basically has a left sidebar that lists stocks that you're tracking and a search field at the top. And most of the space is taken up with news, business news. So you see top business stories. So you can look through your list here and see how your stocks are doing for that day. Now you can also edit these. There's a little button here at the bottom. Click on that. And now you can remove a stock you're not interested in, like that. Or you can rearrange them by grabbing and dragging on the right side there. So you can do that. You can also hit the plus button there and search for a stock and add it. So you can add it by the symbol, or you can search for it basically by the name of the company. And you can hit the plus button and it will add it to your list. So you get this watch list here at the top. So you can now see your watch list here. Hit done. You'll see this new one added. You can click there and now we can rearrange the order. Bring it up there. So you can customize this to be your own list of stocks. Now when you click on one of these, what it will do is it will change from general business news on the right to news specifically for that company and a nice big chart at the top. So looking at the chart here, you can move your cursor through it to see data for a given time. You can also, if you move to the top here, so if you're over the chart, it shows you like that. If you move up, you see one day, week, month, you can go all time, that kind of thing. So you could change the type of chart that you've got there. You can also change from price change to percentage change and market cap as well. So you have those options there. Now the news here that you've got is the news for whatever stock you've selected here. So you can now go and browse that. When you're looking at news stories, you have similar options to that you find in the news app. So you can go, for instance, to view and make text bigger, make text smaller, go to next story, previous story, close the story. You can also save the story to Apple News, since basically this is a view of Apple News here as well. So you have those options. You can also search here for a stock without adding it. So we can search for AT&T here, click on that, jump to it. I haven't added it to my watch list, so I'm just going to view it now temporarily and not add it to my watch list at all. So that's kind of handy. You have some other options as well. If you go into System Preferences and iCloud, you notice that one of the options now is Stocks in iCloud. So basically you can sync which stocks are in your watch list between your devices. So you can be watching the same stocks on your iPhone in the Stocks app as you are on your Mac in the Stocks app. Also, you can add this to Notification Center. You just get a basic list here. You can do that in the Today view of the Notification Center, or you can go in System Preferences to Extensions Today, and you can see Stocks is now one of the options there. So you can have it in the view on the right side of your screen in Today view. So Stocks is a handy new app that you can use to track stocks. And if the news that you like to read is more business oriented, certainly this might be a better option maybe than even viewing news in the news app. You can of course add things here that are not company stocks. You can add things like the S&P 500 and Dow Jones, basically choosing Yahoo. So if you know the Yahoo code for something like for the price of gold or some index or something like that, you should be able to search for and add it to your watch list in the Stocks app.